Alright, hello everybody, welcome back to another tutorial for me here with Strix D. Today I'm gonna explain on how to replace the marked CVPI styled and the unmarked CVPI styled vehicles textures for flashing lights. I'm gonna replace the Utah Highway Patrol skin, which I just made, which I think is absolutely fabulous. So the only thing you will have to need is a skin, obviously, which you can get on applemods.com. Or you get, and you need asset bundle extractor, which I already have to open. So go ahead and go to file, open. Then you want to go to your flashing lights folder, which I have set a pinned thing. Just go to common flashing lights data, and then load up resource assets. Alright, and then it's going to be the following names you want to replace. So once you're in there, you need to go ahead and scroll for the name. So go ahead and go to view, search. And then for the marked CVPR, it's going to be Vic Body Police D. I will leave the locations in the description below. And obviously it's not going to find it because I have a space in there. It's actually, yeah, it is capital and everything like that, so... it will search for capitals as well, which is kind of shitty, but I guess. Alright, let's go ahead and go to edit, loads, and then you want to load your skin. So in this case, it's going to be the Utah CVPI. Then OK, and then you press OK again. And then for the unmark, it's going to be Vic Body D, and then Stripe True, which is going to be this one. Make sure it's always a texture file. If it's a material file, you don't want to replace that because that's actionable texture. Even though you cannot replace it, so that's why you will get an empty list. So before you guys ask questions already, make sure it's always a texture file. Alright, go ahead and go on OK, then you press load, and then you do the same here, either CVPI or any other skin you desire. And then you press both times OK again, and that's pretty much it. That's how you replace the CVPIs. So you want to press OK, you want to say yes, I'm going to save this obviously. You're going to want to go to Steam Games, I'm going to hit this quick. Yeah, I want to replace it, fuck it. And pretty much you can also save it on desktop, it doesn't have to be on Steam Games, but for some reason my PC has an issue with that. So I'm going to put it on desktop, that way it's the same that you guys mostly have. So at this point, you want to open your flashing lights data, which is going to be in common flashing lights and flashing lights data again. You want to put resource assets in there and you want to make sure it's replacing it. And that's it. So now you can start off flashing lights and check out your new CVPR skin. Alright, so let's go ahead and pick us the CVPI, and here you go, both are fully skinned, looking absolutely amazing. Alright, let's go ahead and use the Slick Top. I love that. I really enjoy Slick Top T, but that's, I don't know, it's some kind of thing. And yeah, so as you can see, it works. Maybe I need to redo it back a little bit, but yeah, it looks absolutely amazing. So yeah, go ahead and go in here, here you go, all the lighting still works. Need to rework the back a little bit, but that's it. Alright, so hopefully this helped you guys out. If you have any questions or feedback, just let me know in the comments. You can also join the Flashing Lights Discord, and there we have like 4 or 5 people. If you have 4 or 5 people that actually do supporting for modding, so you can always go ahead and visit there. They can help you out, or I can always help you out if that's needed. And other than that, hopefully this tutorial was very useful. And if you have any questions, make sure to let us know. Other than that, I have nothing else to share. So I'm gonna wish you a very nice day. And on to the next tutorial, I would say. Bye.